In constructing this vocal sound, let's start with the distressor. The distressor for me is main go-to plugin for vocal and just about almost every vocal I've done, especially all the early DMX stuff. When the distressor first came out back in the 90s, I've always used it. I have one in my rack right here. I love it. And this is a go-to setting that I use for vocals most of the time. So the Nas records, the DMX records, all that, that's all using the distressor. And with this setting, it's the opto setting. I'll go to the 10:1, and the attack is either wide open all the way, you know, past 10 or all the way down to 8. It depends on how much I want to cut in. I'm not really looking to get the big attacks. I'm looking to hold the whole vocal down, just kind of squeeze it all together. I'm not going for the transients, although it will catch a lot of them. I could dig a lot deeper into a faster attack, but I'm not interested with this to do that. I would just want to decrease the dynamic range of the entire vocal. Having said that, also what's important about this setting here is how I've got the detector and the audio are important. For the detector, I'm bypassing the low frequencies. So I don't want the compressor triggering off any low frequency pops or foot stomps or anything like that that may be present in the vocal. I don't want that. So I'm going to eliminate that from the detector. And also Dave Durr, the inventor of this plugin and the distressor, he's got a mid-frequency detector. I think it's around 1K somewhere. So to catch harsh frequencies, it's a sidechain detector. So you're not going to hear any kind of curve. It's just, it's detecting those frequencies and triggering the compressor off just those frequencies. Now, as far as the audio signal pass-through, I've continued the high pass here. So the high pass is cleaning up the low frequencies there. I believe it's at 100 or 80. It's somewhere in there. I don't think he would put it too high, but I actually don't even know where it is, but it works great. And I always use the distortion 2 setting, the yellow light, for vocals. I mean, distortion 3 has its uses, but it's just a little too much of an overdrive and you actually hear the crackling. So I prefer the distortion 2. It's a little cleaner. It adds a little bite and a little pith and grit to the vocal. And generally I set my input level. I hit it pretty hard. The distressor is very transparent. And you can smack it pretty hard and it'll take it. And without, you know, messing up the sound, you know, or sounding overly pumped. So, you know, I'm generally well into the yellow on peaks and I'll even get into the red a little bit, you know, 12, 14. I'll push it up there. So let's go back to the setting I had here. And let me just solo here the first half a little. We can do some in and out with it. Let me get a little loop going here. And I'll play with the settings a bit so you can see what's going on.
Never been a hero, but I wear the cape for you. Say the day for you, make them play for two. Know you're tired of being a hero, but I wear the cape for you. Say the day for you.
Listen to that first line where he says, hero. He's really popping it. It's really moving it. And then he kind of goes away.
Never been a hero, but I wear the cape for you. Say the day for you, make them play for two. Know you're tired of being a hero, but I wear the cape for you. Been a hero, but I wear the cape for you. Say the day for you, make them play for two. Know you're tired of being a hero, but I wear the cape for you. Say the day for you, make them play for two.
Well, it definitely smoothed it out, so that's working for me. But let's take a listen real quick without the distortion, because the hero does get a little hot. Let's try it without the distortion setting.
Never been a hero, but I wear the cape for you. Say the day for you, make them play for two. Know you're tired of being a hero, but I wear the cape for you. Say the day for you, make them play for two. Know you're tired of being a hero, but I wear the cape for you. Say the day for you, make them play for two. Know you're tired of being a hero, but I wear the cape.
I think in this instance, because he's so loud on the hero, we're going to leave the distortion off and just let it be clean. It's cleaner without it. We're going to rock with that. So, you know, even though we have preset settings and settings we like, you always have to listen. You always have to, you know, you have to deal with what you have in front of you, not what you did last week. So, and even though I've used this plugin a million times with that distortion 2 on, for this instant, for his voice, for where it's and how hot he recorded it, we're going to go without it because it's cleaner.
I
I never been a hero, but I wear the cape for you. Say the day for you, make